knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
We are nearly through our survey of innate immune cell types, so let's cover one more. Innate lymphoid cells, or ILCs, are a family of lymphocytes that are considered the innate counterparts of T cells from the adaptive immunity. They secrete cytokines that respond swiftly to pathogenic tissue damage and shape subsequent adaptive immunity. These cells share some tasks with T cells and are present in both lymphoid and non-lymphoid organs. They are found in abundance in mucosal surfaces and shape the mucosal immunity in the gastrointestinal and respiratory tracts. The ILC family is characterized by the typical lymphoid morphology and the absence of rearranged antigen-specific receptors such that they do not exhibit antigen specificity, which is unique to T and B cells. Most of the studies regarding ILC development stages have been elucidated in mice. Scientists first demonstrated that ILCs and adaptive immune lymphocytes originate from a common lymphoid progenitor, CLP. Two populations of cells have been shown to demonstrate the ability and restriction to generate all ILC populations. Thus, they cannot differentiate into B and T cells. These are known as alpha lymphoid progenitors, or alpha LPs, and early innate lymphoid progenitors, or EILPs. These cells lack specific transcription factors and markers necessary for B and T cell development. The alpha LP population differs from CLPs in their expression of the integrin alpha-4 beta-7, CXCR6, and the absence of CD135, FLT3. Similarly, the transcriptome of EILPs is similar to CLPs, except that EILPs do not express ILC lineage-specific transcription factors such as ROR gamma-T, GATA3, TBET, or EOMS. Downstream of EILPs, or alpha LPs, distinct ILC lineages have been identified. Importantly, a key distinction between the two lineages is based on the dependency on the transcription factor GATA3. Helper ILC subsets require GATA3 for differentiation, whereas NK cells can develop normally in GATA3 deficient mice. The developmental pathways of ILCs in humans and their respective transcription factors are less well defined compared to ILC development in mice. Recent research suggests that all human ILCs can be generated via an ROR gamma-T plus developmental pathway from a common progenitor in secondary lymphoid organs. The nomenclature for ILCs proposed in 2013 classifies these cells into groups 1, 2, or 3, each of which contains 1, 2, or 3 subsets. ILC1s, ILC2s, and ILC3s mirror CD4 plus T helper cells, TH1, TH2, and TH17, respectively, in terms of function, whereas natural killer cells belonging to ILC1 mirror the functions of CD8 plus cytotoxic T cells. ILCs can be categorized into subsets with defined phenotypes and functional profiles, but they also have the ability to exhibit plasticity and can adapt to local environmental cues by changing these profiles. This highlights the extent to which the cytokine production profiles of ILCs are pre-programmed, but it is also a direct reflection of the tissue microenvironment these ILCs are in. In humans, ILC1s are NK1.1+, NKp46+, CD49a+, CD49b-, TRAIL+, CD69+, CXCR3+, and CXCR6+. ILC2s express surface markers such as IL7RA, CD25, ST2, SCA1, and KLRG1. ILC3s are NK1.1-, NKp46+, CD127+, and CCR6±. One of the earliest identified ILC subsets was characterized as CD4 plus CD3 minus hematopoietic cells involved in the generation of lymphoid tissues during fetal development. They express alpha-4 beta-7 integrin and lymphotoxin and are now defined as lymphoid tissue inducer cells, or LTI cells, due to their essential role in promoting secondary lymphoid tissue organogenesis. The development of LTI cells requires the transcription factor retinoic acid-related orphan receptor gamma T, ROR gamma T, 13, and are therefore assigned to the ILC3 subset. ILC1s are weakly cytotoxic and function as a first line of defense against infections with viruses and certain bacteria. They produce interferon gamma as their main cytokine and are dependent on the transcription factor TBET for this function. This subtype includes NK cells and non-NK cells. Tissue-resident ILC2s are defined by their capacity to produce type 2 cytokines, IL-4, IL-5, and IL-13. They provide an innate immune response to parasites such as helminths. ILC3s are primarily found at mucosal sites and are involved in the innate immune response to extracellular bacteria, as well as the containment of intestinal commensals. They mainly produce IL-22, which is a key cytokine involved in maintaining intestinal homeostasis and promoting the proliferation of intestinal stem cells. ILCs also play an important role in respiratory infections, asthma, allergic rhinitis, and chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Respiratory infection studies include mice studies, which have shown that ILC2s promote epithelial and goblet cell proliferation, as well as mucus production in the H1N1 influenza virus infection model through secretion of amphiregulin and IL-13. These functions result in restoration of the lung epithelial integrity. In asthma, ILC2s play a pathogenic role during lung allergy and inflammation. For example, ILC2s promote allergic lung inflammation by secreting IL-13, which in turn initiates the migration of activated DCs to the draining lymph node where they prime Th2 differentiation. ILC2s have also been implicated in the pathogenesis of allergic rhinitis. The high frequency of ILC2s positively correlates with disease severity. COPD is a disorder caused by long-term cigarette smoke or exposure to noxious gases. Mice studies have demonstrated that lung-resident ILC2s acquire an ILC1 phenotype and secrete interferon gamma during COPD. Moreover, high ILC1 numbers in the peripheral blood of patients directly correlates with severe COPD. The role of ILCs in intestinal infection has been demonstrated in various mice experimental models. For example, ILC3s participate in the immune responses to infections by Citrobacter rodentium, Clostridium difficile, and Salmonella enterica, to name a few. ILC3s counter bacterial infections through secretion of IL-22, which stimulates epithelial cells to produce antimicrobial peptides. ILCs may also impact intestinal viral infections. A majority of the studies in mice have focused on bacterial infections. However, some studies have shown a protective role for ILC3s during rotavirus infections, in which IL-22 synergizes with interferon gamma in inducing activation of transcription factor STAT1. ILCs have been extensively studied in autoimmune disorders, specifically intestinal autoimmune disorders, and particularly inflammatory bowel disease and intestinal cancer. To exploit ILCs as a valid therapeutic target, more human studies have to be conducted, as studies in mouse models have provided limited answers, though they are mainly performed in RAG-deficient mice that lack adaptive responses. And with that, we conclude our study of innate immune cells and the innate immune system in general. As we have come to realize, this system is unbelievably complex, and yet it is nothing compared to the astounding mechanisms of the adaptive immune system. Let's move forward and start tackling this system next.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.